Welcome back to part 3 of 4. In this session, we will cover the following: define and discuss common data elements, the attributes of data management systems, discuss data privacy and security, and data storage. The concept of a set of descriptors for a variable or a question is the basis for a common data element, or CDE, and their use is encouraged when developing CRFs. The use of CDEs, or data elements, as a basis for data management is a logical and efficient approach to clinical research. Metadata can be easier to revise and reuse as compared to the maintenance of multiple non-harmonized or non-standard sets of CRFs that each implement a different version of a set of questions. Questions need to be defined precisely and consistently to support discovery across a registry of content. Metadata registries, such as the ISO-based Cancer Data Standards Registry and Repository, also known as CADSR, maintained by the National Cancer Institute, provides a data element inventory at both the individual data element and the CRF level. The use of terminology concepts to create data elements cements their meaning across programs that reuse elements for diverse reasons. This can be true for a research site or a sponsor. It also allows the establishment of relationship between data elements, ultimately supporting data sharing. Initially labor-intensive, the use of CDEs or metadata is conducive to supporting very large research groups or multi-institutional research efforts. The use of remote data capture, or RDC, is increasing. Generally, concepts for the design of ECRFs, or RDC screens, are the same as for paper. Advantages of RDC include faster data collection, cleaner data collection due to system built-in checks, easier monitoring, central database for storage of all trial data, near real-time data access to authorized personnel. There, however, are some specific training issues that are relevant to electronic data collection, including training on the importance of security. This includes the need to protect passwords, as well as the enforcement of security system and processes, as well as ensuring the user confirms they accept responsibility for data entered using their password. The list of individuals who are authorized to access the EDC system should be maintained, and these individuals should be listed on a trial's privacy risk assessment. Ensure the system can record which user is logged in and when. There should also be a timely removal of access when no longer required or no longer permitted. Confusion about the difference between a clinical data management system and a clinical trial management system is common. A CDMS is associated with traditional approaches to clinical trial activities. There's a heavy data management component with collection of data on paper or electronic CRFs. Data is cleaned and transported to various reporting destinations. In a newer paradigm, a CTMS is a means to integrate data from many systems, such as labs, genomics, and adverse events, enter and clean the data in expedited steps and store it in a repository that can serve multiple purposes over time. Key to CTMS operations is the concept of services or capabilities, such as the ability to handle patient randomization at the same time as adverse event reporting and creating laboratory report alerts for a clinician. An abundance of CDMS and CTMS systems are available from software vendors. In order to evaluate one of them as part of a purchase activity or create supporting training materials or policies, sites and sponsors need to stay focused on criteria that can be used to evaluate them. This includes focusing on what their organization or company needs to accomplish its missions in terms of operations, reporting, connectivity with other systems, and overall capability. The most beneficial way in which to evaluate electronic system is to formulate a set of criteria before viewing any product demonstrations. The danger of losing sight of core requirements in the face of appealing products is very real and potentially devastating. Though there are differences in these systems, I'll refer to these as data management systems for this session. CDMS applications are designed to scale, to grow as needed without loss of function or data. This is paramount since ability to predict data management needs over time can be limited. Scalability must be considered from the inception of a project since it impacts the ultimate success or failure of a data management system implementation. A system that is easy to use, easy to teach to others, completes tasks as expected in a minimum of time, and produces output reliably and efficiently is an excellent candidate for adoption by a large community of users. In settings where performance improves, even with the addition of more users, the system is considered to be scalable. However, in the beginning phases of a CDMS implementation, it may take some time for performance improvements to surface due to the adjustments in work processes and learning a new system. Interoperability is a key attribute for any successful data management system. Interoperability refers to the ability of the system to exchange data in ways that preserve the original meaning and the intent of the data. Is it a function of both the system and the data itself, using data and exchange standards that facilitate aggregation and sharing? The ability of systems to function together is part of a new approach for improved electronic system. For example, data from a laboratory system or registry of medical images represents a huge and valuable addition to a traditional set of clinical data. Instead of manually entering the data from one application into another, which is known to be extremely time-consuming and filled with potential for error, it is more desirable to have data from these systems integrate or combine as appropriate to create a richer data flow. Data can be housed in a single repository or pulled from several sites in the form of a report or a query as needed. Interoperability is also the function of the data itself. The ability to query the content and aggregate or extract data with the same meaning. This is particularly key in the current era of big data, where sheer volumes of data impact the ability to produce reliable data in a timely manner. Quality data management systems are widely accepted external standards in which meaning of the content being collected is documented and widely accepted. Instead of a set of loosely and locally defined data points that need to be redefined with each successive trial activation, a comprehensive prospective set of data terms can be used and reused and expanded over time in a much more efficient approach to the implementation of a data management system. The increase in the use of terminology that facilitates the ability to share electronically has added concerns for security and privacy of information. Clinical research funded by federal agencies should follow Federal Information Security Management Act, also known as FISMA, requirements to meet privacy and security standards. The Act requires that federal agencies develop, document, and implement an agency-wide program to provide security for the information and information systems that support the operations and assets of the agency, including those provided or managed by another agency, contract, or another source. Federal agencies may require documentation to ensure that the systems used to collect or state data comply with FISMA requirements. These include, but are not limited to, 1, a process for detecting, responding, and reporting security incidents, 2, periodic assessment of the risk to the system, and 3, security awareness training. A sponsor or regulatory agency may ask the research team to provide compliance documentation, which can be obtained from the Information Technology Department. The Health Insurance Portability and Accountability Act, also known as HIPAA, defines protected health information, PHI, as identifiable health information transmitted by electronic media, maintained in electronic media, or transmitted or maintained in any other form or medium, such as information in medical records, which may include health status, provision of healthcare, or payments that can be linked to a specific individual. HIPAA pertains to health information collected and used in research studies and activities in a setting related to patient care process and covers all humans living or dead. Examples of PHI include names, social security numbers, addresses, and birth dates. When creating CRFs and databases, you need to remove all potential PHI and use unique identifiers instead. It is important to mention that the data is ultimately kept in a system that will ensure the data integrity and security. If paper is being used at a site, then the site needs to ensure that they keep all research-related records, including all CRFs, in a locked cabinet and preferably a locked room. If electronic CRF system is being used, then the system should reside on servers that have backup and recovery systems in case of disaster or loss of data. Many organizations are storing their data in central data warehouses or data repositories so that other investigators can access the data for secondary analysis. If a study is funded by the NIH or other U.S. government agencies, the data should meet federal record retention requirements so that the data is available under the Freedom of Information Act. In this session, we learned a common data element is a set of descriptors for a variable. CDEs standardize the way in which data elements or questions can be asked, collected, stored, exchanged, and reported. Attributes for data management systems Electronic data management systems are tools that enable health professionals to collect, store, exchange, and share data in increasingly efficient and meaningful ways. Clinical data management systems are associated with our traditional approach to clinical trial data-related activities, while clinical trial management systems have a means to integrate data and processes from many systems, including lab results, adverse events, enrollment, and more. CDMS and CTMS applications are designed to scale, to grow as needed without loss of function or data. Interoperability refers to the ability of systems to exchange data in ways that preserve the original meaning and intent of the data. We learned about data privacy and security. When creating CRFs, all potential PHI must be removed and unique identifiers used instead. Some examples of PHI include names, social security numbers, addresses, and birth dates. Data storage. If paper CRFs are being used, then the site needs to ensure that they can keep all research-related records, including CRFs, in a locked cabinet and preferably a locked room. If an electronic CRF system is being used, then a system should reside on servers that have a backup and recovery system in case of disaster or loss of data. Let's review a couple of questions. Can you tell me what is a common data element and what are the advantages of remote data capture? Thank you for your time.